Good day. You're watching PTS English News. I'm Ethan Liu. A former airport official and his wife have been detained as they're suspected of cooperating with a drug ring in exchange for bribe payments. Investigators discovered tens of millions of NT dollars in cash that Xu could not explain based on his income level. The Investigation Bureau is also trying to determine if he's involved in last year's case when 6.5 kilograms of amphetamines were seized at the airport, but somehow mysteriously disappeared.
Last year, the Investigation Bureau made headlines when it somehow lost 6.5 kilograms of seized amphetamines. The Bureau responded by transferring or demoting various officials. Prosecutors suspect it was an inside job and finally have a lead 4 months into the investigation after searching the home of a former aviation base official surnamed Xu. Four people were brought in for questioning.
并扣押与收入显不相当之相关账户、现金及名牌包、名表、汽车等物。同时传唤徐姓调查官夫妻等四人到案说明。
Apart from finding luxury cars and designer watches in Xu's possession, prosecutors found accumulated cash flow of over 10 million NT dollars incongruent with Xu's income level. His accounts have been frozen. A court approved prosecutor's detention orders for Xu and his wife.
被告涉犯贪污治罪条例第六条之一的财产来源不明罪责，犯罪嫌重大。且被告与证人的证述供词不一，嫌有串证之余，应予收押禁见。
为基于侦查不公开原则，相关细节不便透露。
The original case dates back several years to when narcotics were discovered at the aviation base, and the staffer charged with delivering the narcotics to the Investigation Bureau somehow accidentally lost them. The base initially took matters into its own hands by trying to track down the drugs, but gave up after a year. The matter didn't come to light until the Investigation Bureau got involved.
Emerging drugs have become more popular in recent years. Experts say they're sometimes mixed with laughing gas, which is nothing to laugh about as it took 143 lives in 2020.
Armed police officers climb to the second floor dance hall and begin the raid. The Taoyuan police have received a report that drugs were being sold at this large dance hall. They arrested numerous foreign workers and questioned them at the scene. They also found drugs such as super ecstasy and ketamine on their bodies and brought in nearly 100 people for questioning. Five foreign workers were transferred to prosecutors on suspicion of selling drugs.
那现场有查获疑似涉毒的越南籍移工有上百人，那并查扣第二、三级的毒品及手指物等证物。
The drugs seized in the raid included PMMA, which is also known as super ecstasy. It is a category 2 narcotic with a high toxicity and fatality rate. It killed 93 people in 2020. Emerging drugs have become more prevalent in recent years. The Taiwan High Prosecutor's Office said emerging drugs killed 143 people in 2020. They had on average 4 types of drugs in their bodies, showing that people are frequently mixing drugs. Young people have also been found to mix emerging drugs with laughing gas. Emerging drugs are commonly made from mefedrone, nitrazepam, and nimetazepam. Some inhibit the central nervous system while others are stimulant. They become more dangerous when mixed.
获得一个四级毒品里面有九成是第三级毒品喵喵的先驱原料二溴四甲基苯丙酮。那我们知道喵喵又是混合式的一个毒咖啡包中最常见的一个成分，所以这个部分是我们要注意的一个部分。
The office said the majority of the 2-bromo-4-methylpropylphenol confiscated last year were smuggled from China. Although fentanyl has not been found in Taiwan, global intelligence shows it may arrive soon. Marijuana is now widely and easily available, so it could become more common as well.
It took 2 weeks for the number of people getting the AZ vaccine to reach 10,000. Lawmakers are calling for a vaccination holiday to encourage more people to get vaccinated.
It took 2 weeks for the number of people getting the AZ vaccine to reach 10,000. With frontline medical workers reluctant to get the AZ vaccine due to numerous reports of side effects, it is a real possibility the majority of the 117,000 vaccines received by Taiwan may expire unused. One lawmaker says the Tsai administration should encourage vaccination by following South Korea and Japan's lead in granting a vaccination holiday.
为什么就不要直接大方一点，就是说好，你们就是有几天的这个接种疫苗的疫苗假嘞？
那我想在相关的假期，我们要尊重这劳动部，他们考虑会比较全方位。
Health and Welfare Minister Chen Shizhong told lawmakers discussions with the Ministry of Labor would continue and the ministry would submit a vaccination holiday plan to the Central Epidemic Command Center soon. Asked about new strains emerging around the world, Chen said Taiwan will accelerate domestic development of second-generation vaccines.
根据科学的证据，也会做这样的一个考量。那也希望在国内的疫苗生产之后，能够自己有相关的一个针对变异性病毒的一个研发的能力。
Chen also said scientists expect new strains of COVID-19 in the future, and everyone needs to stay calm and proceed one step at a time.
Now, bring you some top stories from around Taiwan. Leaders and staff at Taiwan's Hestia Power, which received support from Industrial Technology Research Institute, form a new company in China with a similar name, even the same logo, raising trade theft and national security concerns.Han Zhongzhi, the initiator of the referendum to protect algal reefs, said he reiterated his demand during his meeting with the agriculture minister, which is moving the third LNG receiving terminal from the Datang coast. A Teacher Zhang Foundation survey found that 9th and 10th graders are likely to turn to drugs due to interpersonal issues, which will in turn increase the suicide rate.China sent 20 fighter jets to Taiwan's southwest airspace, causing tensions to rise in the strait. Some believe it's due to a memorandum of understanding recently signed between Taiwan and the United States.
Okay, thumbs up.
China recently sent 20 fighter jets into Taiwan's southwest airspace after Taiwan signed a Coast Guard-related memorandum of understanding with the U.S. The PRC's Taiwan Affairs Office says the move was in response to Taiwan and the U.S. challenging China's bottom line.
台湾是中国领土的一部分，解放军在维护国家主权和领土完整进行相关的演训活动是天经地义的，给岛内民众带来了沉重的负担和灾难，最终呢，利益受损最大的只会是台湾。
The TAO also said China would continue to increase military pressure on Taiwan to deter U.S.-Taiwan military cooperation and that Taiwan would be the biggest loser if this continues. Donald Trump's departing gift to Taiwan was the cancellation of diplomatic restrictions. The Financial Times believes the Biden administration will issue new diplomatic guidelines for Taiwan.
民进党当局呢，长期不择手段地拉拢美国一些议员来炮制各种的涉台议案，为其台独的图谋服务。这种勾当呢，迟早是要失败的。
不大张旗鼓地弄嘛，那么现在好像变成是一个正式的、公开的，他们担心就是说，这个是一个将来会不会很多事情也这样弄。
Two members of Congress recently proposed a Taiwan Relations Reinforcement Act that would promote the head of the American Institute in Taiwan to the rank of ambassador. In response, the Taiwan Affairs Office is calling on the U.S. to act appropriately and put a stop to Taiwan's ploys to seduce members of Congress.
5-2 water restrictions will go into effect in Taichung and Miaoli on April 6 due to the drought. The Miaoli County Council is outraged because where there are 5 water reservoirs in the county applying Taichung and Hsinchu, but it's the first municipality to face water restrictions.
Water restrictions will go into effect in Miaoli, Taichung and northern Zhanghua on April 6. The Miaoli County Council is up in arms.
公参评议，我向政界给我们的答案是一样。灌到我们的抗争，
这个不平等的待遇哦，爱搞人倒沙缸，搞人背水一关，你该记住的。
County councillors say there are 5 reservoirs in Miaoli supplying water to other municipalities, and Miaoli should not be the first to face water restrictions. Taichung residents, meanwhile, are busy buying and installing water towers, which are now in short supply.
排到明年都还做不完吧？因为目前现况就已经欠200多颗了，加农农林林总总加起来，差不多有200多颗，快300颗了，一直交不出来。
One water tower company says it has been fulfilling 80 to 100 orders a day for 2 weeks, which is 2 times the usual volume. A Taiwan water company pipe in Tainan was recently discovered to have been leaking for a week.
调配的时候，尤其在夜间的时候，它的一个空气会比较多，造成它没有办法完全密合，它这个整个操作正常，所以说造成有这样子泄漏出来。
The water company says the leak was caused by a malfunctioning exhaust valve that has since been fixed, but not before tens of tons of water were wasted. There are people that are turning to mountain streams for drinking water, but doctors warn that parasites and bacteria can be an issue if the water is not properly sterilized.
Now, let's take a look at some international news today. A new wave of infections has emerged as Iran celebrated New Year, which reported over 10,000 new cases on March 30th, the highest number in 3 months. PayPal said it has started allowing U.S. consumers to pay with cryptocurrency at millions of its online merchants globally, a move that could significantly boost the use of digital assets. In broad daylight, Manhattan, a 65-year-old Asian woman was kicked to the ground by a man who police say made anti-Asian statements. New York police are still searching for him. Children's Day is almost here. New statistics from the Health Promotion Administration show that cancer is the fourth leading cause of death for children and youths under the age of 18.
The latest statistics published by the Health Promotion Administration show that cancer is the fourth leading cause of death for children and youths under the age of 18. In 2018, the five most common types of childhood cancer were leukemia, lymphoma, germ cell tumors, neuroma, and epithelioma. Childhood cancer has a higher survival rate than adult cancer.
相较于我们成人的五年这个全癌症的五年存活率的六成，它是高达八成，因为儿童的这个生命力很强盛哈，还有它的细胞再生的能力很好，所以我们还是呼吁哈，那个家长哈或者照顾者可以透过身体的接触，早期的发现孩子有没有一些异常的症状。
As children are not as expressive as adults, having parents and caretakers stay vigilant is the best way to detect tumors early. Childhood cancer expert Ling Dongtan says medical care should be sought immediately if children suffer from an unexplained fever for more than a week, experience enlarged lymph nodes or aches, or see bruises or bleeding points.
This is the 小朋友本来三四岁哈，他本来玩啊，筷子拿好好的，哎，最近常常会掉，哎，他就来了，哎，真的有脑瘤。那甚至有的也是洗澡的时候，哎，肚子有东西哦，哎，来找，哎，还真的是有哦。对，现在的期数大概都比过去我们的年代好。
Lin says childhood cancer is not necessarily incurable, and the five-year survival rate is around 80%. Children also have a higher tolerance for chemo than adults. Parents are reminded to remain vigilant so that cancer can be detected and treated early.
Thank you, and see you next time.